系你准备平安，今天是不给接过，不给第三，不给分第三的主日。阮感谢主有通三甲来敬拜咱的上帝。菲律宾现在是面对这个疫情的情况，求主来保守阮每一个人的平安的出入。但请你记得耶和华是咱的力量，是咱的盾牌，是咱的患难中间随时的帮助。咱依靠阮的上帝来经验着这段的时间，上帝照顾及上帝保守。阮三甲祈祷将这段的时间交到主的里面。感谢上帝，阮虽然伫这个疫情的中间，阮无通面对面聚集咧，但是阮有通伫门顶撒个来敬拜阮的上帝，保守阮和阮信靠阮的上帝。虽然讲耶和华是阮力量，是阮的盾牌，是阮伫患难中间随时的帮助。求你帮助阮每一个兄弟姊妹，每一个家庭，伫这个疫情的中间，有你家己少数十分的平安。虽然现在这个 Delta 这个 variant 真厉害，但是上帝啊，阮相信你的恩典教育阮的需要，保守阮的每一个人的平安，而做阮专心专意、真心真意、尽力来侍奉敬拜阮的上帝。将早起这段的敬拜的时间交到主你的手中，求主的灵甲阮同在，献出阮的感恩甲阮的祈祷，奉靠主耶稣基督宝贵的圣名。Amen。你这边咱大家用西瓜来阿罗咱的上帝。
Now by your grace we come. now by your grace we come.
Peace, brothers and sisters.
咱继续思想苦难之美这个系列的信息。
Let's resume our series, The Mystery of Suffering.
今日咱的题目是作出丰盛。
Today, our message is entitled The Restoration from Hopelessness.
这是约伯记第四十二章。
This is found in Job chapter 42.Today, we'll be concluding this message series. I do hope that we already have a deep understanding on suffering. When we and our friends suffer, let's not explain it immediately.That it should be like this or it was like this. We are not God.There are many things we do not understand. I don't know if you've noticed. In the past 30 years, I have not rebuked anyone who was late for service. I might encourage you not to be late. But I have not rebuked you. Do you know what the reason is?When I was a pastor for my first year, one time in a service, the service has already been halfway. The message has already been preached halfway. And there was a 16-year-old girl who came in. And the preacher got very mad.And he scolded her. He said, Do you think you are watching a movie? That you'll just come in whenever you want to come? And he said a lot of rude things. And this child kept on crying. And she left the sanctuary.And this became a big issue. Because they found out that although she was late, there was a legitimate reason for it. From that day onwards, I decided not to rebuke anyone from the pulpit. Because I do not know what the reason for being late is. Church. When people are late, we may not even know the reason. And we're not even talking about suffering. Let us lift up the answer to God. What we can do is to walk with those who are suffering. And this is what the book of Romans says. Rejoice with those who rejoice and mourn with those who mourn.Today we'll be concluding in Job chapter 42. Let us discuss the purpose of suffering and the outcome of suffering. Let us first look at the purpose of suffering. In chapters 42, 1 to 6. Now in these six verses, This is the second time God spoke to Job, and Job has now responded. In this moment of response, we see two things. Job has come to know God better, and Job has known himself better.And this is the purpose why suffering befalls us. Let's look at the first. Suffering allows us to know God better. We can find this in the first three verses. Then Job replied to the Lord, I know that you can do all things.No purpose of yours can be thwarted.
Now
You asked, who is this that obscures my plans without knowledge? Surely I spoke of things I did not understand, things too wonderful for me to know. In these three verses, we see two things.
The first,
that God is omnipotent and omniscient. Let's look at the second verse. I know that you can do all things. No purpose of yours can be thwarted. This is saying that God is Almighty. The first time the word Almighty appeared in the Bible is in Genesis chapter 17, verse 1. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. This is what God told man. I am God Almighty. There is nothing I cannot do. Abraham, you are 99. Your wife, 89. Next year, you'll be 100. And your wife, 90. But you will still be able to bear a son. This thing I will do.
And
Isaac was born in their old age.
This
is proving that God is really an almighty God. No human weakness. No human powerlessness. Or evil forces can stop the fulfillment of God. Before God has even declared, Job has already known. He said, God, I know you can do it all. And suffering gave Job a deeper understanding. In the past, in Job chapter 40, verses 15 to chapter 41, verse 34, God showed Job two monsters. However, the Bible does translate it as the hippo or the crocodile. But in chapter 40, verses 15 to 24, it refers to the behemoth as a kind of monster. Some people might say that this is the dinosaur. And chapter 41 talks about a monster that lives within the sea. And the point of these two monsters means that no one can control them. No one can subdue them. Only the Lord Almighty can.
Almighty God.
For He is Almighty. After Job recognized that God was Almighty, he also saw that he was perfect and beautiful. Let's look at verse
3.
Who is this that obscures my plans without knowledge? Surely I spoke of things I did not understand, things too wonderful for me to know. Who is that that obscures my plans? Now this statement is not from Job. This is God speaking to himself. And Job is using this statement to explain something. Do you remember Job chapter 38 verse 2? God asked a question. Who is this that obscures my plans with words without knowledge?
Now,
the who in the original text is referring to a singular person.
是指一个人,
it is only one person.
是指约伯,
and this is Job.
上帝跟约伯讲,
so God is telling Job,
是你用无地位和我的旨意无清楚。
You're the one who spoke words without knowledge.
然后上帝用了四节圣经来解释。
And God used four verses to explain.
Four chapters
to explain.
38到41节。
From verses
38 to 41.
And he asked Job 70 questions.
约伯没有这个问题回答案。
And Job could not answer a single one.
现在,
now,
约伯用上帝的位。
God, Job quotes God.
神啊，用无地位和上帝旨意无清楚啊。
Now who is the one that obscures my plans without knowledge?
又是说约伯承认就是我 I am.
He is admitting that he was wrong.
我用无地位和上帝旨意无清楚。
He said, I am the one who did this.
所以刚才说，以及上帝说 I am sorry.
So he told God, I am sorry.
哎呀，我的话都是无知的话。
I spoke in ignorance.
因为我讲的话，连我自己都不知道讲什么。
Because I spoke without understanding.
你说上帝，你是太奇妙，too wonderful.
God, you are too wonderful.
Too wonderful is 原文是，太奇妙，所以 too beautiful, too wonderful.
In the original text, too beautiful.
所以约伯承认上帝的旨意之美。
So Job admitted that God was indeed absolutely wonderful.
感谢上帝.
Thank God.
我们在你记得当约伯受苦的时阵,
I don't know if you remember Job's suffering.
约伯怀疑上帝.
He wanted to reply to God.
甚至跟上帝去来辩论去 debate.
He wanted to debate with God.
甚至要求跟上帝去法庭杀毒.
He wanted to even meet with him face to face.
在法庭里面的court.
In the court.
你看第9章10节.
Let's look at Job
9:15.
Though I were innocent, I could not answer him. I could only plead with my judge for mercy.
27. Verse 20.
Even if I were innocent, my mouth would condemn me. If I were blameless, it would pronounce me guilty.
33.
If only there was someone to mediate between us, someone to bring us together. What are these verses talking about? Job felt helpless.
我有理,
he said, I am righteous.
但是没人听我讲话,
but there is no one here to hear me out.
没法跟上帝debate,
I could not debate with God.
哎呀, 但是经过苦难以后,
and after experience suffering,
约伯说上帝你的旨意是奇妙，是美的。
He told God, your will is truly wonderful.
所以苦难后约伯认识上帝beautiful, wonderful.
So suffering allowed Job to see how wonderful and beautiful God was.
第二，苦难让我们认识自己。
Suffering makes us know ourselves better.
第42章第4到第6章。 From verses 4 to 6.
Listen now, and I will speak. I will question you, and you shall answer me. My ears had heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you.
因为这样，我厌恶自己。 而是还问出我厌恶自己的话，在尘土及炉灰中间懊悔。
Therefore, I despise myself and repent in dust and ashes.
你注意第4节。
Let's look at verse 4.
求你听我，我要讲话，我问你，求你指示我。
Listen now, and I will speak. I will question you, and you shall answer me.
这句话也不是约伯讲的。
This is not the words of Job.
是上帝讲的。
This is the words of God.
约伯重新引用上帝的话。
This is the first time God spoke to Job.
因为你记得第38章第3节。
If you remember in chapter 38:3,
当上帝跟约伯讲话的时候,
when God was speaking to Job,
他跟约伯讲,
he told him,
你要用事束腰，我问你，求你指示我。
Brace yourself like a man, and I will question you.
第40章第7节。
In chapter 47,
如果跟约伯说，你要用树束腰，我问你，你有听指示我。
Brace yourself like a man, and I will question you, and you shall answer me. God is humble. He told Job twice, if I have committed wrong, can you tell me? And now Job is using God's own words. Of course, he is not answering God. He is replying to God. He has responded two things. The first statement, my ears had heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you. These words coming from the mouth of Job is not very simple. Because Job knew God very well. His understanding and knowledge of God would exceed many believers. But after suffering, now he says, my ears have heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you. Before I've only heard of you. But now I have seen and experienced you. Just like seeing someone with your eyes. The second statement, therefore I despise myself and repent in dust and ashes. Job is saying, I despise myself and the words that I have spoken. Job realized he has spoken ignorantly and casually. And he has disrespected the Lord.
Repent in the dust and the ashes.
So he says he will repent in dust and in ashes. He admitted his own mistake. If you were to combine these two statements, we see that in suffering, not only did Job know God better, he has also known himself a lot better. Job is a good man. He feared God and loved men. He was a blameless man on earth. But in the deepest depths of his heart, there was darkness. In suffering, it unconsciously came out. Because he thought that he was unequal to God. And he asked God for an answer. And he demanded to debate with God. Because he thought he was equal with God. And then Elihu rebuked him. He said, God is greater than man. How can man argue with God? Please focus on this. Job did not suffer as a consequence of sin, but in the process of his suffering, Job committed mistakes. I am not saying Job had committed sin, but he has disrespected God. His words and his attitude were wrong. He was self-righteous and he was prideful. So after suffering, he has known himself better. So church, when God's purpose allows suffering in our lives, it allows us to know God and know ourselves better. So do not waste the crisis.
Don't waste the crisis.
Because only that will allow us to understand God and ourselves better. Otherwise, the suffering will be wasted. Let's look at the outcome of the suffering.
第42章7到17節.
In verses
7-17.
Now these 11 verses would describe the end of Job.
是約伯更加苦難的結局.
Which is the outcome of his suffering. We see three things. Job prayed for his three friends. Job was blessed abundantly. And his family was also blessed. And these three things are three different conclusions. The first, Job matured spiritually. Job was blessed by God. And Job was blessed by men. Let's look at the first. Job spiritually matured.
第七到第十节,
from verses 7-10,
这四节的圣经是记载上帝与约伯三朋友发烧气.
These four verses recorded God's anger against his three friends.
你看第七节,
let's look at verse 7.
耶和华对约伯讲，约伯讲话以后对提问人以利法讲， 我的烧气与你及你两个朋友发作， 因为以议论寡，无亲像我仆人约伯所讲的事。
After the Lord had said these things to Job, he said to Eliphaz, the Temanite, I am angry with you and your two friends, because you have not spoken the truth about me as my servant Job has.
Verse 8.
So now take seven bulls and seven rams and go to my servant Job and sacrifice a burnt offering for yourselves. My servant Job will pray for you, and I will accept his prayer and not deal with you accordingly to your folly. You have not spoken the truth about me as my servant Job has. This is very meaningful. These three friends were the defense attorneys for God. But God did not compliment them. But God instead rebuked them. He said twice that you have spoken wrongly about me. So church, if you do not know, then you don't know. Don't casually speak for the Lord. God will not pay for the bill. God told his three friends, he said, take seven bulls and rams and go to my servant Job and sacrifice a burnt offering for yourselves. And my servant Job will pray for you, and I will accept his prayer and not deal according to your folly. God wanted Job to intercede for them. Job was to mediate for them, to pray for these friends. If you were Job, what would you do? These three friends kept accusing you and said that I was a sinner and said my children sinned and they deserve to die because God is fair and said that in the darkness I have committed a lot of sins. Therefore, this is God's retribution. I tell you, there's no need for such friends. Now they want me to pray for them.
No way.
No, no, no more. But that's not what the Bible says. In chapter 42, verse 10, that Job prayed for his friends. This is what the Lord says. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. And we see that Job matured even more spiritually. The second,
蒙恩。
The Job was blessed by God.
你讲第四十二第十节。
Look at 42:10.
伊讲约伯对伊朋友祈祷，耶和华就让约伯对苦境中间转回，并且耶和华赐福因，俾伊从前所有的加倍。
After Job had prayed for his friends, the Lord restored his fortunes and gave him twice as much as he had before. Let's look at verses 12 to 15. The Lord blessed the latter part of Job's life more than the former part. He had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. And he also had 7 sons and 3 daughters. The first daughter he named Jemima, the second Keziah, and the third Keren Hapuk. Nowhere in the land were there found women as beautiful as Job's daughters, and their father granted them an inheritance along with their brothers. Now this is the result after Job prayed for his friends. God blessed him.
Double blessing.
Have you noticed that all his possessions doubled? If we compare it,
第一週, 有七千隻的油,
in the first chapter, he had 7,000 sheep, now 14,000.
第一週有三千的駱駝, 變成六千.
He had 3,000 camels, but now 6,000.
500
pairs of oxen, now
1,000.
500 donkeys, now
1,000.
So everything he had doubled. So double is not only in the material aspect, but also spiritually. Because the eldest son would get double portion of the blessing. So in God's eyes, Job was his eldest son. This is a spiritual blessing. Now in the aspect of children, God did not give him 20 children. God continued to give him 10. What's the difference? The difference is the three daughters had a name for themselves.
Chapter 1,
the first chapter, his three daughters were not named. Now his three daughters are named. The first is Jemima. The second is Keziah. The third is Keren Hapuk. All these names meant that their daughters were very beautiful. That across the whole earth that there are no women as beautiful as they.
Imagine. Miss Universe.
Imagine that Job's household had 3 Miss Universes. In the Old Testament, the beauty of a man and a female would represent the blessing of the Lord. You might perhaps think of a problem. Why didn't God give him 20 children? Because life is very precious. You cannot use a life to replace another life. Although we do believe that the first 10 children are already in heaven. So in heaven, Job will have 20 children. But he has still lost his children on earth. The loss of his 10 children will still be a painful part of his life. Maybe this is the cost of growing mature. The third, Job was blessed before men. Let's look at chapter 42, verse 11.
第一个来杀到个米杰邦，各轮到耶和华所讲，及一切灾难，拢为伊悲伤安慰伊。大家人送伊一块金，及一个金环。
All his brothers and sisters and everyone who had known him before came and ate with him in his house. They comforted and consoled him over all the trouble the Lord has brought on him. Each one gave him a piece of silver and a gold ring.
Let's
look at verses
16 to 17.
After this, Job lived 140 years. He saw his children and their children to the fourth generation. And so Job died, a man, an old man, full of years. Not only did Job find favor in God, he found favor before men. Back then, Job suffered sores all over his body. Everybody who saw him was afraid and they left him. Everybody believed that he suffered because he was a sinner.
So
they treated him like a leper. When they saw him, they would run away. But thank God. God moved his brothers and sisters and his relatives and his friends. Each one of them visited him. Not only did they visit, they comforted, they encouraged him. And when they left, they gave him gifts. They would give him a piece of silver and a gold ring. If you think about it, if today the world's population would visit you, and everybody would give you 1 peso, do you know how much money you would have? Today there
are 7.8
billion people on earth. So if everybody gave you a peso, you would have 7.8 billion pesos. You would be one of the richest people here in the Philippines. Now what if they gave you $1 instead of peso? You would be the second richest person in the Philippines.
Imagine.
Job was like this. God allowed Job to be comforted by all these people. And all of them blessed him, comforted him. And Job received a lot of grace. Not only that, he lived a long life. He lived 140 years. We don't know how long Job suffered. But according to the scriptures, I say it might have been only a few months.
Maybe six months, half year.
Maybe just 6 months.
But
imagine.
For example,
let's say he suffered for 6 months. But God blessed him 140 years. You compute it. God's blessing is larger than the suffering he gave. Not only that, he saw his grandchildren to the fourth generation. There's a Chinese saying that says five generations existing side by side. Church, as we conclude this series on Job, and as we continue, suffering continues to be a mystery. And when righteous people suffer, that is even a bigger mystery. And suffering is a challenge to relationships. But let us remember one thing. God will not abandon his children in times of suffering.
苦难会让上帝离开咱。
Suffering will not allow God to leave us.
苦难是让咱有通甲上帝建立更加亲密的关系。
Suffering allows our relationship to grow even more with God.
苦难让咱更加明白自己。
Suffering allows us to know ourselves even better.
So, 当你发现你边头人面对苦难的时阵
，So when you find out the person on your side is suffering,
你免赶紧甲一切苦难的原因是啥物
？Do not rush to find the reason for his suffering.
免赶紧表达你的意见的 opinion.
Do not immediately express your opinion.
你的同在已经是第一道安慰。
Your presence is the greatest comfort. May God bless everyone in this period of suffering. And also help us to encourage those who are in suffering. Let us pray.
God is good all the time our God is good 良善信实的上帝帮助你的家里面对苦难和教会帮助在苦难中间的那个时候不是只是切出原因解释和我们知道面对苦难的原因在哪里面对苦难的意义在哪里更加重要，及苦难人实际经验着这个苦难的时阵，何君照圣经的教导，及喜乐的人有通实际喜乐，但是你悲哀的人实际哀哭。特别君喺做君的感谢，帮衬君接到这个苦难之美这个系列的信息，何君每一个人实在对苦难更加有比较更清楚的了解，那是了解有通帮衬在君背后面对苦难的人。现在我们的感谢，现在我们的祈祷，继续保守君所落去，而且特别君面对菲律宾这个彭达米，全世界这个彭达米的中间，君相信无上的人仍然在苦难的中间，和君采取别人的鼓励、安慰及挑战来念不上帝。感谢主，听我们的感恩，及我们的祈祷，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名。Amen, Amen。现在这边对。
Brothers and sisters, from August 22, which is next week, until September
26,
we will continue with a new message series. It is talking about family. The series is entitled A Family After God's Own Heart. We know that family is the most basic unit of society. A healthy family would contribute to a healthy society. And a family is also the church's unit. A healthy church would only stem from healthy families.
So we need to take a help for Shonday's Sim Ye Tiong Hu Tai Tai Lao Be Lao Mu Gap Kiani Che Kokdola Sushong.
And with this series, we'll be discussing on how to be a husband, a wife, a mother, a father, and a children after God's own heart. May God help us. In this series, the last week, our church will hold its first ever family summit. In the last week, from Friday to Sunday, we will invite speakers with experience and expertise to talk about these topics. To understand better our responsibilities and our roles within the family. On September 26th, which is the last week of the series, we will culminate the end of this family summit. So please do pray for this new worship series. And also pray for every family. If you want to get more details on this family summit, please watch the family summit video.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Hi, I'm Ronald, and this is my wife, Irene. And we want to invite you to be part of CBCP's first ever online family summit. I think this will be true for most, if not all, families. The quarantine disrupted our daily life. Our work setup changed, and suddenly I had to work from home. As a business owner, I need to handle problems at work, but since I can't be there personally, it felt limiting. At the same time, there are needs and concerns to attend to for the family at home. Having to adjust to all of this happening at the same time was quite stressful.
Like my husband, I'm also working full-time in my professional and ministry engagements. And when the pandemic hit, we didn't have any household help. As a homemaker, I personally like to keep our house perfectly clean and organized, but I couldn't do it because of my workload. So after some time, I realized that I was having feelings of guilt and frustration because of this. I felt like I was letting my family down, and this only added to the emotions I was already struggling with.
During those times, prayer and time with the Lord allowed us to find solace and stillness, to sort through the stressors that are overwhelming our home.
I'm also very thankful that open communication is something that we've been working on as a family through the years. I think that no family is immune to fights and emotional outbursts, but at the end of the day, I'm thankful that my family strives to be a safe space for each one of us to express frustrations and clarify assumptions. I found out that my family was not demanding of me to keep our house perfectly neat and tidy. They were also very supportive and understanding of me.
We worked out a division of labor at home because we knew that each of us has other responsibilities to attend to. During this season, we've developed stronger camaraderie in our family. Plus, I certainly enjoy that we are bonding more during mealtimes.
It is not easy, and we still need to keep working on ourselves and consistently go to the Lord for wisdom and strength to face challenges and changes brought about by the pandemic. But we also praise God as we see His hand working in us, teaching us, and transforming our family for the better.
This pandemic is causing a lot of burdens to my family, but we can truly say that this season brings with it blessings that are worth striving for.
We hope that you and your family can join the summit and learn more about how we can make the pandemic situation at home from burden to blessings. See you there!